Do you know how resilience affects one's life? It's like muscles in your mind, so it can make you even a stronger and greater person than before. Overcoming life adversity. This resilience meant so much to my life. I will show you how it worked on me. I was born several years after the Korean War that pushed Korea into one of the poorest nations in the world. So, it was extremely hard for me to survive each day as a little boy. Then, strong optimism began to grow in my mind. Such a bouncing positive mind guided me as my own mentor to overcome various hardships on the way and inspired me to become a successful person. Then, a major hardship covertly approached me like a shadow. Since 8 years ago when was in early 50s, I began to feel uneasy in moving from time to time. But, I didn't care much about it as I used to be a physically fit person, with 3 black belts in martial arts. In January 2011, however, I was finally confirmed with Parkinson's. Would you know what happened right at that moment? I spontaneously made a big smile and said, "Thank you for the confirmation, doctor. As my future time horizon now is uncertain, I am determined to live my remaining days 3 times happier than before." Then, I started swimming to recover my wearing body conditions every day in Manila, and now back in Seoul. I have so far swum around 2,500 kilometers, keeping it on, no matter how harder it has become. A new dream to become a swim coach to help others who may need my help, came up to me. And, the dream came true after a few years of hard training. Early this year, I became a swim coach, together with my wife Michelle, who used to be aquaphobia, specializing in teaching a unique water survival method which I named Leaf Float Survival Method. Last year, I found out, while spending much time floating on my back, especially during off times, that this floating I do every day can be taught to others for good purposes. So, I and Michelle together developed a yoga swim for PD patients, using the Leaf Float, which we together presented to the Asia Parkinson Forum in Tokyo in September. At the same time, my head coach Paul and I developed a fresh new systemic program of Leaf Float Survival Method, the world's first non-swimming floating for survival. In case of a water accident, we have trained government lifeguard teams and their trainers, so that they can teach our Leaf Float method to citizens officially. Also, we are pursuing a plan to develop easy swim methods for PD patients and other disabled people. Then, I started up a global Save Children from Drowning volunteering campaign. For its first mission, I visited Mindoro Island in the Philippines early April, bringing a group of trained youths with me to teach about 300 teenagers how to float on the sea like a dry leaf for survival, awaiting rescue to arrive. This remarkable campaign was a huge success, as you can see in the video, and covered by various news media. I cannot forget the beaming faces of the girls when they learned how to float by themselves safely for the first time. My journey towards this life-saving will never stop, until a new floating mankind has emerged. Thank you.